Hello dear friends, let's continue the game making series. In the previous video, we made trail effect. In this video, we will make the game more aesthetic by using particle system. We will create 3 different particles. Fold particle, movement particle and touch particle. So you will have improved a little more in making games. Alright, let's get started. I will remove the trail renderer component. As you can see, the player has a trail effect now. Let's create dust behind the player while the player is moving. Right click on the hierarchy panel, go to effects and then select particle system. Rename it to movement particle. Particle system created by default. We're gonna customize the particle system. I drag and drop the dust image I created earlier onto the assets panel. And then I'll create a material from the dust image for the particle system. Choose the type of the material. After that, drag and drop the dust image to here. Alright, the material is ready. Now we can add the material to the particle system. As you see, the appearance of the particles has changed. The particle system component has many features. We will customize the particle system using these features. If you follow the same steps as me, you can achieve the same result. First, I will change the shape of the particle system. I'll set the particle count to 1. Set the duration to 1. Start lifetime 0.5 and set the start speed to 0. Set the simulation space as world. I will apply an upward force to the particle. I want the particle to become transparent over time, so I'll decrease the alpha value of the particle. Alright, now I want to set the size of the particle. .5 looks fine. I will add rotation movement to the particle to be a little more aesthetic. Okay, movement particle is ready. Now I'll duplicate the particle with Ctrl the shortcut to create fall particle. I'll change some feature for fall particle. Alright, the fall particle is ready too. Now, I'll duplicate the fall particle to create touch particle. Don't forget to disable looping of the particles. Right click on the player and create an empty object named particles. And then drag and drop the particles into the particles. Okay, the particles we will use in the game are ready. Now let's determine in which situations these particles will be played. Select the particles object and create particle controller script. Open the script. First, let's do the movement particle. occur after velocity is the speed the player must reach for dust formation. Save this script and test it. Go back to Unity. Start the game. Movement particle is constantly occurring. If I set occur after velocity to 1, the movement particle is only generated when the speed of the player exceeds 1. With dust formation period, we can set the period of dust formation. You can find the most suitable values for you by trying. As you can see, movement particles are generated also while the player is in the air. I only want it to occur while on the ground. Open the particle controller script. I created new variable named isGround. I added this variable to the dust formation condition. When the player touches the ground, isGround variable will be true. When the player leaves the ground, isGround variable will be false. Go back to Unity. Select particles and add box collider to detect touches between player and ground. Adjust the size of the collider according to the player. Make sure enable collider trigger option. And of course, I'll change the tag of the wall as a ground. Start the game. As you can see, the movement particle only occurs while the player is on the ground. Let's go ahead and activate fall particle. I will play the fall particle as soon as the player touches the ground. Go back to Unity. Drag and drop the fall particle to the slot. As you can see, the fall particle spawn as soon as the player touches the ground. I want the particle to appear behind the wall. So, I'll decrease order and layer of the particles. Looks better. Movement particle and fall particle are ready. It's time for the touch particle. Open the particle controller. I'll add a new method named playTouchParticle. I will call this function from within movement controller script. Open movement controller script. First, I will add particle controller variable to access particle controller script. And then, I'll call playTouchParticle method when the player touches a wall. Back to Unity, drag and drop particles object to the slot to access particle controller script. Then, drag and drop touch particle to its slot. You can use header to tidy the script. Go back to Unity. Start the game. Particles spawn when player hits a wall, but not at position we want. Let's solve this problem quickly. You can also solve this problem in other ways. If you have anything to ask, you can write in the comments. Start the game again. Nice! I want to increase start size of the movement particle. Looks fine. To be tidy is important in a game making process. How do you think? Did you like it? Please specify in comments. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.